إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد Brothers, sisters and my dear friends hope that my voice is audible and my voice is clear Okay, please write in chat box. Okay, welcome all of you for a session where we are learning one important pillar of our Islam, that is the zakah. Hope inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will this time our skill of good deeds, because we are learning something which is related to our deen, which is important part of the deen. Brothers and sisters, zakah, each and every Muslim knows, but the one who has the nisab means the minimum amount liable for the zakah, he must know all the rulings of the zakah. That is compulsory. Like the prayer is individual obligation, similarly, zakah is individual obligation for the one who has the money, who has the wealth. So let us go for some explanation of the zakah as a reminder for all the people. You know, there is a linguistic meaning and there is a religious meaning. This point, each and every Muslim should keep in the mind, because for not knowing this point or this important principle, always there is a confusion. The language before the Prophet ﷺ was Arabic, but they were not knowing zakat, they were not knowing salah, they were not knowing lot of azan, for example. So they were using the words of azan in the linguistic meaning. But when Islam came, it gave the religious meaning also. So right now, there is a huge confusion among the community and the society. They read the translations and they implement the ruling. That is a huge mistake, because translation is linguistic translation, linguistic meaning. Religious meaning is totally different. For example, Salah. Linguistic meaning is prayer. What is the religious meaning? Religious meaning, you know that a lot of conditions are there. Pillars are there. Adabs are there. Standing, sitting, tashahud, invoking blessing on the Prophet. This is the religious meaning. So brothers, please note down that only linguistic meaning does not give complete picture of religious rulings. Marriage in the secular countries, in the Christian countries, in the non-Islamic countries might have some definition. Arabic language also has this definition of marriage, husband and wife, man and woman, they are living together, something like that. But religiously, marriage is certain conditions and a total definition. So zakah has a linguistic meaning. What are those linguistic meaning? Okay, and there is a very strong relation between linguistic meaning and between religious meaning. So zakah means increasing. Linguistic meaning, zakah is one of the meaning. And inshallah, we come to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised, and the Prophet ﷺ has promised, that whatever believers spend for the cause of Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it never decreases his money. The Prophet said, مَا نَقَسَ مَالُ مِنْ صَدَقَةً charity, sadaqah. And the best sadaqah is the zakah. That means best giving, because it is the pillar. The other things are the optional, honorary. So no wealth ever decrease due to the charity. The Prophet ﷺ said, وما أنفقتم من نفقة فهو يخلفه. If you spend something, Allah will give you more. That is in the Quran. Subhanallah. So anyway, one of the meaning is increase. Because the zakah is spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligatorily. Annually, certain percentage of the saving money is spent. So that is increase. Purification also. Tahirahum wa yuzakkihim. Tazkiyah. Purification. Purification from the greediness. Purification from misery. Purification from the jealousy. Purification. Lot of. For spiritual purification, soul purification. That is one of the meaning. Blessings or praise, that is also comes one of the meaning of the zakah. So brothers and sisters, this is a linguistic meaning. But what is the religious meaning of zakah? The religious meaning of the zakah is we did not mention here. Religious meaning of the zakah, a certain portion of the wealth, a certain portion of the wealth subject annually for giving as zakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Certain portion. It is not all that you have to give. It is not a lot of portion. So it is certain portion. While it reached to the minimum liable amount. That is called in Arabic, nisab. We will explain it. Anyway, so religious meaning is certain portion which should be given as the charity annually when the savings or the wealth reach to a certain level or certain amount. That is the okay, brothers and sisters. Let us see which amount it should be given and which amount subject to the zakah. Jurisprudential meaning, that is the religious meaning I said. Payment of a portion of the wealth, certain percentage of the or portion of the wealth should be paid. For that, intention should be there. Okay, in the malamalu binniya, you may give millions of the dollars for the charity, but if it is not to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey the Prophet, then you will get the reward in the dunya, not in the akhirah. Aisha radiallahu anha, narrated, one of the famous people, Abdullah ibn Judan, he used to feed the people and give the charity. But he did not embrace Islam and he died. So Aisha radiallahu anha asked whether it will benefit him or not. So the Prophet said, Innahu lam yaqul qat rabbi ighfirli. He did a lot of charity actions, good deed, but he never said, O Allah, forgive me. O Allah, forgive me. That means he did not believe in that. So brothers, it should be one of the important conditions that the intention should be there for giving the zakah. And from one's own wealth, the person, it should be in the real ownership. Milkun tamun. So this comes in that religious meaning to a defined category, and zakah should go to special people. Not anyone it deserves. Applicable when certain conditions of wealth are fulfilled. Which wealth which is subject to the zakah? These are the details. All this, you know, that weak definition which needs a lot of explanation. How is my wife's brothers? Are you, it is clear for you people? Audible? Hello, am I clear? So can I continue? For few seconds I stop to check whether my voice is clear or not. It's okay, alhamdulillah. So in religious meaning, a portion of the wealth with the intention of the worship to a definite fixed category, and applicable when certain conditions are met. So these are the things which needs, because it is a legal language and religious meaning, so it needs a need little bit explanation also. Okay, I would like to remind myself and my brothers and sisters, please keep in the mind, religious meaning must be kept in the mind. And also, religious words has his own meaning. We should not mix up. Islamically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet and the scholar, they have used for the charity. In English, we don't have except charity, donation, something like that, simple words. In other languages also, but in Islamically, there are a lot of words which is mentioned. For example, sadaqah is there. What is the sadaqah? Zakah is there. Zakah is totally different from the sadaqah. So conditions of the zakah, rulings of the zakah, and other things are different from the sadaqah. Conditions of the sadaqah, rulings of the zakah, different. And gifts. Gifts are totally different. From the sadaqah. And the rulings of the gift, conditions of the gift is different. Similarly, the word waqf, ijara, rent, and atiyah. Right now, the people that take the bribe and they say it is gifts. Or it is service charges, which is rishwa. Rishwa is bribe. So what I mean here, we should not be confused. We should know what is zakah, what is sadaqah. Because when we say sadaqah Islamically, it's ruling us totally different from the word of sadaqah. So there are other words, tabarru also, endowment also, a lot of things are there. Zakah is the pillar of Islam. It has totally different rulings. While the sadaqah also a charity, so which has the totally different rulings. So why I raise this question? Because generally we mix up. We think sadaqah is and zakat are all the, or if we translate it as the charity, we think or we take it as the charity, we are doing something good, yes. Brothers, you are doing good deed, yes. But to make it worship, to follow the guidance of the Prophet is compulsory. So as for the zakah, it is not charity, it is not sadaqah. Zakah is zakah. Zakah is compulsory. Sadaqah is not compulsory. So zakah, for example, it can't be given to certain people, while the sadaqah can be given. So a lot of differences are there. So if you say gift, the ruling is different. If you say service charges, rulings are different. If you say it is endowment, rulings are different. If you say it is mahar, it is the this or it is bribe. So rulings are different. So various words are there which should be very careful about dealing with the zakat. What is the zakat? What is the ruling? You must know that. Okay. The third point is the zakah is mentioned a lot of times in the Quran. أقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he has ordered only one time, for example, it was sufficient. But many times sorry for the interruption. There was some technical problems. We have changed it. Might be inshallah my voice will be clear right now, and inshallah communication will be easy. So brothers and sisters, you can see my screen. So various definitions of the various Islamic words. So there is a difference between the zakat and between the sadaqah, between the change and another person change and another person change, then deen will not remain as the solid, protected, preserved deen. So as for the religious matter, we have to just take from Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The scholar, they explain it, that's it. So anyway, so after knowing that zakah has a separate individual and special rulings, and it should not be considered as the charity, I went to the mention of the zakah, importance of the zakah. It is in the Quran, in the hadith. It is in the Quran, it is in the hadith, in the concepts of the Sahaba, Muslim of scholars. So Allah mentioned in the Quran, even if he have mentioned one time, it was sufficient, but he has mentioned many times. 30 times he mentioned clearly, aqimus salah wa atu zakat, not the root words, clear words. So Allah said, O people, establish the prayer and pay the zakat. So it is in the Quran. Okay. And in the hadith, lot of hadith. One of the very famous hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, "An Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu, Buni al-Islam wa ala khamsin." The pillars of Islam is five. Islam is based on five pillars. Establish. Number one, shahadat la ilaha illallah, wa iqami salah, wa ita'i zakah. So he mentioned five pillars. One of the first is shahadat la ilaha illallah, wa iqami salah, ita'i zakah. It is in the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أُقَاتِلَ النَّاسِ حَتَّى يَشْهَدُوا أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So I have sent here to spread the truth. Okay. When I spread the truth, people will fight me. But I will fight until they accept لا إله إلا الله. That means he is not forcefully fighting, but he spread. When the people fight, he will fight for this cause. To spread the لا إله إلا الله and to establish the prayer and zakah. So is it clear, brothers and sisters? It is in the hadith, and there's a lot of ahadith also. Okay, one of the very famous hadith in this regard, there is a discussion between Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu. When the Prophet ﷺ died, so a lot of people in peninsula of Arab, they said, we don't pay zakah. They were believing in La ilaha illallah. They were believing in establishment of the prayers, they are performing the prayer, but they say no zakah, we will not pay. Lot of people. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said, see here, you people should pay the zakah, otherwise I will fight you. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he discussed with Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he said that they are saying la ilaha illallah, believing in la ilaha illallah, performing the prayer, how do you fight them? He said that, see here, they were paying at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is part of our deen. If they don't pay right now, so I will fight them because they are changing the deen. So Umar radiallahu anhu tried 2-3 times, then Abu Bakr Sistan, his explanation make him to accept. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the heart of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu for the truth, subhanallah. So anyway, so this hadith is, and this discussion is very famous. And then Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu sent the people and tell them, go there and ask them to pay the zakah and accept it as the obligation of the deen. Otherwise, you know that we will fight them. So this is the way Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu once again established Islam. So the scholars have consensus that those who don't pay will be forced and fought. Will be forced means if they are believing in Islam. And we are not dealing with those who don't believe in Islam. We are dealing about the community. We are believe those who are believing in Islam. If they believe in Islam, they must pay the zakah. Otherwise, they can leave Islam. It's okay, up to them. But if they are in Muslim country under the Muslim rule and they are not paying the zakah, so it government will not accept it. Like, you know, zakah for taxes. In any government, the people, they don't pay the tax and they fight the government will punish them. So similarly, in the Islamic government. Fight means when they, for example, they made a group and powerful resistance, then the government take the proper steps to crush them and to break their power. So, okay. So then, let us go after the conditions, importance of the zakah. So benefits of the zakah also it is mentioned in the Quran. One thing is that it is the part of Islam, pillar of Islam. A person, he claims that I am Muslim and he neglect the zakah, means his iman is in danger. If he denies, then he is not a Muslim. He does not believe in Islam at all. You know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to spend for his pleasure. So it is getting the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have 100 rupees. Just we pay 2.5 rupees. So 97.5 is with us. So 2.5 is for the needy and poor people. And that also Allah is promising that I will give back more than that. So brothers, what you are giving is how many times less? 10 times less? No, more than that. Subhanallah, very less amount we are paying, 2.5%. So what you are giving is very less, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising that he will give you more than that. Ihsan, when you do the ihsan with the people start loving you. So that is a strong relation between rich people and the poor people. It is not workers are agitating against the owners and the owners are exploiting the poor people. No, it is Islam. It's a good relation between the employers and the employees. So reducing the love of wealth, you know, people should not attach with the worldly things and they should have the love, mercy, good relations with those people who don't have. So those who have and those who don't have, the gap should be filled. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us that we have to take care of these people. Allah said in the Quran, for example, wa fi amwalikum haqqun ma'lum lis-sa'ili wal mahroom. See here, if you have the money, those who are asking and begging, or those who are not asking, they are deprived of the wealth or blessings of Allah. So they have the right in your wealth. So all the rich people have the right of the poor in their money. Because the rich never become rich until the poor people works for him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided. Anyway, Hasan radiallahu anhu used to advise the rich people. They say, always be thankful to Allah that He made you among those who are giving. He did not make you among those who are receiving. Subhanallah. So He made you in the upper part, not the lower part, that you have to ask the people. Subhanallah. So brothers and sisters, a lot of benefits are there. Some benefits I mentioned, you have seen in my screen right now. So the second point is the zakah is obligation, compulsory, pillar of Islam. From the Quran I mentioned, from the Sunnah I have mentioned, ijma of the Sahaba. Ijma means brothers and sisters. Allah said in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِي غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That all the believers, when they agreed, they agreed upon something, so it become an evidence that it is part of the deen, because the Prophet said, my ummah never agree on something misguidance. Before Islam, Christians and Jews, their leaders and their rabbis and their spiritual leaders, when they say something, they accept it. But in this ummah, all the Muslim scholars, then impossible to agree on something wrong. Might be 90% people accept, but the 10% people, they say, no, it is against Islam, we don't accept it. For that, they will sacrifice their lives. So that is why that is the ijma. This is one of the characteristics of Muslim Ummah. So all the Sahaba, they accepted that the zakah should be paid, and those people who don't pay the zakah, if they are Muslim, they will be forced for that. So that is what I mentioned about the zakah. One of the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, very important hadith in Sahih Bukhari, the people embraced in Yemen. So Prophet ﷺ said, Muaz ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu. So he said, oh Muaz, you are going to Yemen where the people of the book also there. Inna katati qawma min ahli al-kitab. People of the book, that is the Jews and Christians were there in Najran. فَأَوَّلَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ شَهَدَةُ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا. First thing you have to make the dawah is La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. First thing. So brothers and sisters, right now also we have to concentrate on spreading the truth, that is, there is no God who deserves to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what Allah says to Muaz. Prophet said to Muaz. And then he says, if they accept La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, then you tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made 5 daily prayers on them. If they accept it, then zakat is compulsory on them. It would be taken from their rich people and given back to their poor people. That is why the scholar says zakah should be paid where there is a wealth. That means if you are earning in Chennai, you have to pay in Chennai. That is the priorities. Because tu'khadhu min aghniyaihim, from the community where there is a people, from their rich people are there, zakat will be taken from them and given back to the poor people in that area, in those areas. But transferring is allowed, but this is the preferred thing. So why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, Muaz ibn Jabal. So take from the rich of them, give to the poor of them. Okay. So these are the, you know, that hadith and ijma. Okay. Right now, another thing, it become compulsory on whom? It is not compulsory on the non-Muslims. It is compulsory on the Muslim. Second thing is, when it become compulsory. Compulsory is minimum amount that is liable for the zakah. That is called nisab. Okay. Nisab. Minimum limit that makes zakah obligatory. Okay. Second condition. What is the nisab? We will discuss later. So first thing, the person should be Muslim. Second thing, he should own the nisab. Third thing, he should have the complete ownership. For example, he might have the money, but it is in hands of the people. Government has captured his lands, or the robbers has taken the money, people has taken as the investment or as the loan, but did not pay him back. He does not know whether he gets or not. So he does not have the ownership on that. So complete ownership, that is also compulsory. Or he has put money somewhere and he forgot, he is not able to recollect where it is his money. Then the fourth condition is, each year the zakat is compulsory. For example, a woman got married in this Ramzan and she got the mahar 10 lakhs. So she owned that 10 lakhs when she got married first of the Ramzan. Then it become due not after owning the same day of the next day or every month. It become compulsory after 1 year. That is, after passing complete lunar year, having passed a complete lunar year. Okay, brothers, except profit and agricultural productions and cattle's production, because they subject to the capital. New income, which is liable for zakah after 1 year. So these are the conditions which make the zakah compulsory. So nisab is the person who owns the nisab is considered Islamically rich. Ownership, I explained to you. Passing a complete lunar year, Islamic year. It is not, you know, that Christian calendar. It is Islamic lunar year. So it is 356 days, not 365 days, 11 days less. Okay. So when these are the conditions, one thing is, right now we have to know whether the zakah is due in each and everything. No, zakah is due in certain things. One thing is gold, that is subject to zakah. Silver, that subject to the zakah. Cash is basically representing the gold. If you go back 30 years, 70 years back, it used to be written on the all the notes that whenever the person demand from the Reserve Bank, they will pay the equivalent of that amount, the zakah, gold. Right now, they are not writing, but it was there in the old notes. Anyway, so cash is basically representing the gold. Business is liable for the zakat. Trade. Agriculture also, whatever we produce, certain amount should be paid from whatever we get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing from our fields. Cattle is camel, cow, sheep. So these are the cattle, domestic cattle, on which the zakah is liable. So these are the things which subject to the zakah. Okay, brothers. Other than that, generally, we should not pay the zakah for anything else. For example, you know, when we say zakah on the gold, so the question comes, what about the jewelry? Okay, zakah on the jewelry. Basically, we have two strong opinions. Jewelry is considered, because there is a hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَيْسَ عَلَى الْمَرْءِ فِي فَرَسِهِ وَلَا فِي رِقِّهِ أَوْ فِي عَبْدِهِ صَدَقَةً. So whatever he has, horse or the slaves, there is no zakah for him. The Prophet ﷺ said, based on that, the scholar says, so personal thing does not belong, personal thing that belong to the personal use does not subject to the zakah. So right now, jewelry, if you see from the aspect of that it is a personal use of a woman, then there is no zakah. If you see that it is the gold, then there is a zakah. So the some scholar, they look at it as the gold. Some scholar, they look at it as the personal use. And there are ahadith also, but ahadith also, some ahadith suggest for the zakah, some ahadith would not suggest for the zakah. Anyway, So two very strong opinions. So women, if they have the jewelry and the gold and it reached to the nisab. For example, nisab is 85 grams. So a woman, if she has 85 grams of the gold, she has to pay the zakat. Okay. But jewelry, if it is 85 or more, because it is using, so Imam Shafi Rahmatullah Alayhi, Imam Malik, they said, no, does not subject to the zakat. But Imam Abu Hanifa Rahmatullah Alayhi, he says, no, it is gold. So we have to pay the zakat. That is why Indians, most of the Indians, they follow the Imam Abu Hanifa's opinion in this concern and many other opinions also. So that is why it is common in India to pay the zakat of the jewelry. Except in Kerala and that area where the people are following the Imam Shafi's opinion. Anyway, zakah and the jewelry, it is better to pay it. Yes. But with jewelry, sometimes the jewelry is broken. Sometimes jewelry is kept just because it is a wealth. So that time they have to pay the zakah for that. The jewelry which is daily basis or generally frequently it is used, there is no zakah on it. Okay. So that is why I added used jewelry. Unused jewelry, broken, does not come under this category. Okay. Zakah on the used item for brothers and sisters. Might be you have the car. Might be you have your personal house. Might be you have your own buildings where you are living. And your clothes and diamonds, platinum, precious stones, all does not subject to the zakah. Zakah is only in these five items. Okay, if a person's property, his business is real estate, selling the houses, purchasing the houses. So whatever it is for the sale and the purchase, it's subject to the zakah, but not the house where he is living. Might be the house is very expensive, 10 crores, 20 crores, 15 crores, 100 crores. It doesn't matter because it is for him to live there. Personal use. Car also might be 10 lakhs, maybe more than that, but this is the car he is using. So there is no zakah for that. Zakah on used item, there is no zakah on the used item. Houses where the people are living, maybe more than one house also, but it is not for selling and the purchasing. So does not consider as the trade or does not come under the business. If he has the business, then there is a zakat due on that. Anything, for example, cars for using, I have four cars. For example, I am using, my wife is using, my children are using, there is no zakat. But I have one car, two cars, I sell it and then purchase a new one and sell it and purchase a new one. So it is the business, then that it's subject to the zakat. So how to do the calculation tomorrow, inshallah, I will explain it. So precious stone also, might be the people have aqiq and the people have ruby, people have nilam and lot of diamonds. It does not subject to the zakah. Clothes, right now, sometimes, you know, with expensive clothes that people have, but it also does not subject to the zakah. Hopefully it is very clear. Okay, the people might ask about the income and all these things. So income, consider whatever income you have. So whether it is the business income or rental income. So rental income is, the zakah is not due on the house, rental house. Zakah is due on the your rental income. But rental income is not a separate item or separate thing for the subject zakah. It is considered as the income. So you have business, you have your savings, you have your goal, and you have one of the thing is income, tuition income, school income, or services income, whatever it is. This income is considered as the wealth and the cash. End of the year, I will calculate, I will teach you the calculation. I will teach you once again the calculation. So at the end of the year, you will see whatever the money you have, cash plus gold plus business plus savings, then you pay the zakat. Tomorrow, inshallah, I will explain once again. So this is jewelry. The question is there. Explain the jewelry. I told you in the jewelry matters, there are two opinions. You consider this like the women are using their cards. Similarly, jewelry is part of the, you know, that women generally, naturally, they use the jewelry. Oh, okay, the jewelry for the men, it is subject to the zakah because jewelry is not allowed for the men. Okay. For example, the men have the gold jewelry, so they have to pay the zakah because it is not allowed for them. Okay. For the women jewelry, because Allah said in the Quran that awaman yunashya'u fil hilya, so women are these in the jewelry. That means it is part of the nature. So general use of the jewelry which they use frequently or daily basis. Frequently means parties. Yeah, for the functions also, what the jewelry they are using in the function is considered as the necessity. Okay, so this kind of the jewelry, if people don't want to pay the zakah, it is allowed for them. Okay, better to pay the zakah because Allah will give them as per the other opinion. That's it. Jewelry which is broken, old fashion, not using, kept it just only for as the wealth, so we have to pay the zakah for that. Okay, brothers and sisters, so anything else, question, you can write it right now. Otherwise, how much time is left? There are some questions. Zakah on receivable debts. Oh, okay, this, it takes a time. Inshallah, I will explain you tomorrow. Let us go today. We deal with some questions and calculation and the remaining subject about the debt and so other things, recipients of the zakat. Tomorrow, inshallah, I will explain it. Today, we will take some question answers. Let us see. What is the questions, brother? See here, brothers, the question of a person is that he purchased the plot land and he is planning to build the house in the future. So whether he has to pay the zakat on it or not, it is a very common question. Generally, the people they invested in the real estate, might be the buildings, might be the plots, they are waiting. So first of all, we have to decide. We are dealing with our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not with the people. We can cheat the society, we can cheat ourselves, but we can't cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will explain you and you have to decide your intention, not my words. Okay, what is the intention? Why did you purchase first? Why did you purchase? If your intention is to make the house, then it is personal use. There is no zakat. Be clear. Don't cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your intention is, let us purchase this land because I have extra money. If the prices goes high, I get a good offer, then I will sell it. So what is your purpose? Make profit, isn't it? Whatever it is, maybe after 10 years, about 20 years, 100 years, your plan is, you purchase a land 50 kilometers away from city and the city will expand and it will reach after 50 years. If I'm not, my children will get benefit. Whatever your intention, you want to develop your money, increase your money, isn't it? That is business. So that is why if you have purchased any house, any land with the purpose of to sell it after 10 years, 15 years, then it is considered as transactions business. Though you are not a businessman, but you are doing one business, just only one house, one plot. So that time you have to pay the zakat of that plan, that plot, that house every year. How do you pay? What is the value? Might be you have purchased 50 lakhs, but right now due to the down of the market, fall of the market, it is 20 lakhs to pay the zakah of 20 lakhs. Okay, the market went high. So right now it is 1 crore. So you pay the zakah of 1 crore. How do you know? You ask 2-3 people who are reliable in the market. What is the price of that area? You pay it. Hopefully, I'm very clear about it. Okay, houses also. You purchase the house with the intention of just to have some income, rental income. So that time, you take the rent and eat it, consume it. At the end of the year, after 1 year, there is no money, don't pay the zakah. But you have the income, rental income, job income, business, savings, goal, and then this rental income, it goes with the savings, savings, and all together you have to pay the zakah, and how much and how tomorrow, inshallah. But rent, just you get the rent 1 lakh and you pay the zakah, no. You have taken 1 lakh and you have eaten, you have consumed it, then there is no savings at the end of the year, there is no zakah on it. But 1 lakh of the gold you have, so you have to pay the zakah, for example. Similarly, a house, whether you are using or not, but you are planning to sell it, you are waiting for the good offer, plat, you are waiting for the good offer, that time you have to pay the value of the plat, value of the house. Okay. Yeah, I told you that jewelry which is used daily basis or in the functions, if they want to pay the zakah, it is rewardable. If they don't pay the zakah, it is allowed. Yeah, we are talking about above 85 grams of the jewelry. If it is less than, there is no zakah at all. All the people accepted it. See here, the question is that can zakah be given to the husband who is indebted? That means in the debt. Okay. First of all, it is not that he is indebted. For example, myself, I was running a business, 1 crore rupees, 2 crore rupees, 5 crore rupees. I was having a business. Then I lost my business, but still I have my cars, I have my flats, 4 flats, 3 flats, house, lot of things. So question is not indebted, debted. Question is that whether he is needy, poor, need of the money or not. That is the question. First, we have to decide it. If the husband lost the business and to survive, he has sold his properties also. Right now, he cannot meet the daily expenses of his children, his wife. He reached to that level, or still he assets, or still he has, mashallah, maintaining, you know, that good standard of friendship, hoteling, gathering, traveling, holidays, everything is there still. And indebted, yes, indebted, because he lost the business. He has to pay to the people because he was not able to run a successful business. But whatever the debt he has, might be has extra flat, might be has a luxury house, while 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom house is enough for him, but he is living in a villa. So he cannot take the zakah, or zakah can't be given to him. Is it clear? Then if it is in that, not in that case, so wife can give the zakah to the husband, not the husband can give the wife. Why? Because sponsoring is spending. The husband is not duty of a wife. But spending on the wife is compulsory on the husband. So husband cannot give the zakat to the wife because he must give his, you know, that savings, what he owns. But the wife, instead of giving to the other people, she can give the husband. I told you, there is a conditions. Not only debt, not only poor. Some people, they say that I don't have the money, I lost the business. But you lost the business, but still you are rich. So it should be very, we should be and deal very carefully while the matter of zakat is there, because it is the pillar of Islam, it is the worship, and we have to fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while giving zakat. Zakat should be accepted because Allah says only 8 categories, we have to pay in that, those categories only. No, loans and business we will discuss tomorrow, inshallah. If the gold is less than 85 grams, there is no zakah on it. If you want to give something, it is not zakat, it is sadaqah. And you can give the sadaqah whether you have the money or not. Anytime you can give. It is. I told you, sisters, might be the people who are from Kerala sites and you know that coastal areas, these people follow the Imam Shafi Rahmatullah Alayhi's opinion. But the UP, Hyderabad, Bihar, Delhi, Pakistan, all Afghanistan, these people, they follow the Imam Abu Hanifa's opinion. So if you ask the Saudi scholars, so you also see a lot of scholars, they say not compulsory to pay. And some scholars, they say it is better to pay. But they don't say it is compulsory. So alhamdulillah, so if you have 300 grams, so might be 20,000, 30,000 sadaqa annually. Not much. If you want to give, it is rewardable. But we can't say it is compulsory to give. That is also a huge confusion. I would like, hopefully my audience are inshallah, they can cope up with me. I mean that because this is the calculation base and the economical base, so I want that people should understand it properly. So what the question is, that they have the gold, and what they have? They have the money, but they don't have source of income. See here, sisters, see here, brothers. Source of income is the future plan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the doors in the future. We don't know somehow. Anyway. Right now, you are rich or the poor? That is the question. If you are rich today, pay it. Allah will open the doors of the sources in the future. Don't worry about the future. This question is basically because I don't have the future, coronavirus, lockdown, problems, might be something will happen. That is why I don't pay the zakat right now. That is basically, it is the psychology right now. No. Today, I am rich or the poor? Who is the rich? Who owns the 85 gram of the gold? Or who has the cash equivalent to the gold? For example, if a person has 70 grams gold and remaining 2-4 lakhs is the cash. So I told you gold and cash is considered one category. So he has to pay the zakat. Okay? Sources, don't worry. As today you are rich, you pay. And Allah will open the doors tomorrow. If tomorrow you are not able to pay, don't pay. But today you pay it. Okay? Recipient of the zakat, that category we will discuss. The question is that we pay in Saudi a family dependent tax. Brothers and sisters, all the taxes does not come under the zakat, because whether you want or not, forcefully they take you. I mentioned in the zakat, intention should be there. This is the worship. If they are taking your money forcefully, they are fining you. Sometimes they fine you, sometimes take your tax, sometimes GST, lot of things. It is not the zakat. Zakat is only for poor people. It is not Muhammad bin Salman. You give zakat to Muhammad bin Salman. Subhanallah. What kind of these questions? Whether it is there or here. So taxes are not considered zakat, and you cannot calculate from the zakat. Okay. After paying the taxes, after paying the dependent taxes or whatever the expenditure, renewal of the iqama and many things, after paying all those things, you have 85 gold gram or equivalent of the money or not? That is the question. If you have, pay the zakah. If you don't have that amount, don't pay the zakah. Be clear, in India also, taxes cannot consider tax. For example, you know, the government, because of you make mistake in the GST, they fine you 10 lakh rupees. And you come and say, this is zakat. No, zakat needs intention. And also, zakat needs to pay certain people, not the government. So it is not considered as the zakat. Yeah. After paying all this expenditure of the government, maybe it is injustice, it is cruel, it is subjecting the people. Yes, whatever it is you pay, then what is remaining, savings from that, if it reach to the nisab, that time you pay the zakat. The jewelry which is used once and twice every year, see here, you know the purpose of the jewelry. Purpose of the jewelry, you kept it just as the savings or for the purpose to wear it, might be 1-2 times in the year. Yes, you need it, as to wear it because of your position, your status, or not. So you see the intention. Intention is as the jewelry, and you follow the opinion of Imam Shafi, Imam Malik, don't pay it. If the intention is just to keep it as the value, in the future you need it, then you pay the zakat according to all the scholars. Brother, this is the Indian question. Do you know what is the Indian question? Should I pay the zakah for my wife's jewelry? Or should wife should pay? See, in India, concept is that husband money is wife's money and wife's money is husband's money. So that is why when the husband dies, the problem starts, inheritance. So it is considered the wife's money, wealth, or the father's money. So always this is a confusion. Islamically, brothers and sisters, each and everyone is responsible, and each and everyone has to pay the zakah, and each and individual, they should know that who is owning the money. It can't be just in my relatives. Some months back, a case came to me. So father died 10 years back, then mother died just nearby that time, and they are children, they are telling that this house and this houses or properties go old. So you know that how to distribute. I said, first we have to decide whether this belongs to the father and the mother. No, it belongs to both of them. It is confusing how it belongs to both of them. You should be clear. Father, then the rulings different. Mother, the rulings are different. So similarly, brothers and sisters, right now, you, whatever your wife's owns, might be you have given her as the mahar, as the gifts, or her children has given her to her mother, and her in-laws, that means her father, her mother has given you your in-laws. So this is her money, her wealth. She has to pay the zakat. If you want to pay the zakah on behalf of her, basically you are not paying the zakah. You give her or you ask her the permission that I am paying on behalf of you. She has to make the intention of the zakah. You pay. It is a kind of gift for your wife, and it is a kind of help your wife being a good relations. But due on your wife, and you are paying on behalf of your wife. Hopefully I am clear. This is a Tamil Nadu problem. It is not there anywhere in the world. And there is also some people, they raise the question that once you pay the zakah, you don't pay another time. No, once you perform the prayer, don't perform the prayer once again, or what? Hajj, once you perform, you don't perform the another time? No. Zakah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to collect annually. Like the prayer is 5 daily prayers, Hajj is once in a life, zakat is annually. So as long as you are rich every year, you pay the zakat. Anytime you are, may Allah protect you and protect us from the problems. If you below the rich category, richness, standards of the richness in Islam, then that time you don't pay. It is not that you have paid or not. It is not that question. Question is that every year, if you are rich, that means you own the nisab, then you have to pay the zakah. For the same amount, another amount, that is not a matter, sisters, brothers. You are rich, you have to pay. Okay. There are the questions, PF and insurance. You can keep it for tomorrow, inshallah. Okay. Sorry? Yeah, stock investments also tomorrow we'll deal it. This is also a very important question. The person is asking, the brother is asking, or the sister is asking, that they have the land and they want to pay the zakah, but they don't have the cash. Isn't it? Yes, excuse. If you don't have the gold, don't have the jewelry, and don't have the extra things in your use, when you can get rid of them, and that means you can sell it and pay the zakah, pay it. Otherwise, even you don't have all these things that is necessary It's just you have extra things you are not able to pay, then you calculate every year zakat. Right now the land value was 30 lakhs, so percentage of 30 lakhs is 2.5, so whatever 40 lakhs for example, so 1 lakh rupees is the zakat this year. And the next year also you try to pay this 1 lakh, you are not able, then the land value was still, it was remaining 40 lakhs, 1 lakh more. So wherever you are able to pay those 2 lakhs, you pay it. Otherwise, you maintain it. And even after your death, your children should pay the zakat, then they should get the inheritance. Because it is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the right of the poor people. So if you don't have the cash, you can't pay it, and you don't have the gold and the silver and the savings, that time you maintain it and inform your children that zakah is due. Calculate it for 1 year, 2 years, 10 years. You have to pay it. Otherwise, you will be questioned on the day of judgment. Yeah, calculation questions is tomorrow because I did not explain it. Yeah, see here. I told you, intention is compulsory for the worship. The question is, we build a house for rental income, not for the sale. You don't sell it and you don't ask the people what is the price, and you are not offering also for the sale. So just for the income of the rental income. So there is no zakat on the value of the house. Income of the rent, you keep, take it, use it. End of the year, you see. Savings, rent, cash, stock, whatever you own, that you pay the zakah. If you have finished it, no zakah. Yeah, a little bit details of the calculation will come tomorrow, inshallah. Once again, brothers and sisters, please keep in the mind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they want that the each and every day the people pay the zakat. It is not related to Ramzan. Ramzan is only for fasting. Whenever, you know that in the whole world, the people are performing the prayer each and every minute. Some people 7 o'clock, some 7:05, some 7:10, always, because it is, time is changing. Similarly, whenever I told you that a woman got married in Shaban, in Shawwal, in Zilhijjah, she got 10 lakh rupees and she kept it in the bank or she kept it in the house. After 1 year, that is the Zilhijjah she has to pay. She should not wait for the Ramzan. That is the mistake the Ummah is doing generally. When the Zakat, Ramzan comes, they think paying Zakat in the Ramzan is more rewardable or more beneficial, whatever it is. But if you would delay it, you will be punished for that. You will be sin. It is considered as a sin. Don't delay it. So maintain. Whenever one lunar year is over, you have to pay the zakah. There is no hadith which says that pay the zakah in Ramzan. Yeah. For those people who have the different kinds of the incomes, instead of maintaining the incomes, what they said, okay, we will go for Ramzan. Whatever we have, pay the zakah. For example, he has the income just 2 months before the Ramzan, 5 lakhs. But he does not bother about it because he paid on last Ramzan and he will pay. So whatever he got it, gold, silver, business, income, gifts from the family members, from the children. In the Ramzan, she has 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs to pay the zakah. That was how it developed, that to make it easy for the people, they make it Ramzan. But paying earlier is allowed. Delaying is not allowed. It is punishable. Why? Due time is 1 year. So please, you can pay earlier, but you can't pay late. For example, if it is in Zilhijjah, you pay in Zilhijjah. You don't wait Muharram, Safar, Rabi Lawal, Rabi Sani, Jumadil Ula, Jumadil Sani, Rajab, Shaban, Ramzan. 9 month delay. Not allowed. Daughter marriage and zakat. That is also a common question in India. If you ask the same question to the Arabs and to Pathans, they will laugh on you. Because marriage in Arabs means expenditure for the boys, not for the girls. At all. Even one penny. The girls had become rich when they get married. their daughters because the boys, they bring a lot of money. So we are making something mistake, first thing. Second thing, intentions cannot be implemented. It means your plans, maybe she get married, she can't marry. Right now, you have the money. If you want to get married her, marry her, spend the money, there is no zakah. But she didn't get married, you have the plan just, but you are rich, you have to pay the zakah. Whether it is land, jewelry, whatever it is. But if you have done the marriage, finished the marriage, and expenditure was there and no income, that's okay. But as long as just it is a plan, each and everyone plans to get married, each and everyone has the plan to make the buildings. For that purpose, whatever we are saving, we cannot escape from the zakat. We have to pay the zakat. Whether it is the boys, whether it is the girls, or parents. Okay, inshallah, whatever the technical problems was there, it is unintentional. Hopefully, may Allah bless whatever we have said, and may Allah give us the strength to follow the deen and make us steadfast on our deen. Jazakumullah khair. And inshallah, we will continue the same time tomorrow, 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock. And with the same question answer session, we will finish it. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.